Welcome back to another episode of the Qoocam AK. Today, we are going to talk about low light in 360 video. You saw lots of the low light footage shot on this camera in my latest 360 video, which, by the way, just got featured on Samsung VR front page. Hooray! So, how good is the low light? Well, it is not what you think. Let's roll the cinematic intro and find out.
One long, angry line later.
So the reason why I like low light quality of the Qoocam AK besides the larger sensor is because they approach this in a professional camera perspective. They keep the sensor noise and everything in the sensor captured in ISP level and let the user decide what to do with the noise. This is the approach lots of professional camera use, like Red Digital Cinema Camera, Arri Alexa, or even the Blackmagic. Predictable sensor noise is very easy to remove in post-production without affecting your image. As I love to educate my viewers, so you can be a smarter consumer. Let me show you some comparison to illustrate the idea. Here we have, from left to right, Qoocam AK in 10-bit, GoPro MAX, and Insta360 ONE X Color Plus 2.0. They are all in ISO 400 and shutter speed 1 over 120 seconds. High shutter speed removes low light motion blur, which is necessary for this particular scene in VR. If you look at the bright part of the image, both Insta360 ONE X and GoPro MAX look less noisy. It almost looks better. But if you pay close attention to the dark part of the image, like the floor right here, you see fine film grain in the Qoocam AK, but aliasing and denoising artifacts in both GoPro MAX or Insta360 ONE X. If you look at the detail of the floor, like right here, all you see is a mess in GoPro MAX or Insta360 ONE X. All the detail got removed in ISP level, thanks to their internal camera denoising feature. So it removes actual details in the image, and you cannot turn it off. Let's flip the camera to the backside. Now the problem is more obvious. While GoPro MAX seems worse with loss of aliasing, Insta360 ONE X with Color Plus introduced color noise artifacts like the moving green color patch. The in-camera denoising feature in ONE X and the MAX not only remove actual details in the image, it also makes everything soft. Look at this frame. I still look pretty sharp in the Qoocam AK in 10-bit, but in both GoPro MAX and Insta360 ONE X, I look soft like a ghost. Yes, it is less noisy, but it is not usable as the subject, which is me right here, turn into a ghost. Not literally, but you know what I mean. 10-bit color depth. Besides a bigger sensor size and with fine film noise instead of a poor denoising result, another great feature of the Qoocam AK is 10-bit color depth. If you don't understand what is the benefit between 10-bit and 8-bit, I highly recommend you go check out my explain video right here, which I go into detail of the theory. The numbers behind 10-bit versus 8-bit, sensor, dynamic range, and all the good stuff. You will be really camera smart after that video and can argue with even video professionals in the bar.
Hugh?
What?
I think GoPro Max is better.
But did you know Qoocam 8K is 10-bit?
I don't watch your dumb video.
Then you should watch it like everyone else.
They are boring.
You are boring. I'm leaving.
I will tell your mother.
1 hour later.
Let me show you some practical benefit of 10-bit here. As you see the trash can in the distance, there are red and green in these little guys right here. While GoPro Max is colorless, and the Insta360 ONE X, even with Color Plus, still with very faded color. 8-bit color footage also introduced banding when you do color grading in post-production. Let's throw in Lumetri color in all three samples, and we go extreme here to just demonstrate. We reduce the contrast undertone to -150 on all three of the footage. Now we see banding in the sky. In Qoocam 8K 10-bit, we see a gradient fall off of the colors. In GoPro Max and Insta360 ONE X, all we see is banding and artifacts. If you cannot see it because of YouTube compression, you can download this comparison video in 4K, and the link is in the description down below. How to denoise your 360 video? Now, bonus point for those of you want to take control of your camera noise and create a better looking video. You can either leave the noise in and let your video have the film grain look, or you can remove it and clean it up in post-production. I already made a long and very, very in-depth denoising tutorial right here. I even explained how to remove Insta360 ONE X noise, which is close to impossible. If you just want to do it for free, you can throw in a VR denoise effects under immersive video effects to knock out some of the noise. But you know, free stuff never looks that good. If you have the paid version of the DaVinci Resolve 16, again, it is not free, not like some YouTubers confuse you. Resolve for 360 is never free. You can go into color tab and use Temporal NR and achieve a really good result. Here, hit Command plus K to add a note, choose frame 3, and start moving the Luma and Chroma. Again, I don't have a paid version, so you see this giant logo right here. But if you pay attention to the image, it removes noise and the whole video looks super smooth and clean. If you got interested in learning more about DaVinci Resolve 16 for 360 video production, comment below so I know you want to learn and I will teach you. Thank you for watching another Qoocam 8K video and denoising tutorial. If you want more content like this, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. Comment below and tell me what you think about the Qoocam 8K compared to GoPro Max right here and the Insta360 ONE X. And go check out this 360 video in your Oculus Go or Oculus Quest if you have not, so you know how good or bad is the Qoocam 8K. Now it is officially available on Oculus TV, so no more YouTube VR compression and you can see it natively on Oculus. Yes, Oculus TV is like Netflix for VR. So click the link in the description down below and add it to your VR headset and start watching. And I will see you in virtual reality.